Hello and welcome back to the online classes once again. In my previous video, I had given you some exercises from my practice time 5 and 6, and some of the students, they got confused with some few questions to which I'm going to explain it right now. Okay, so from my practice time 6, I will do question number 2E and 3E. Okay, so which is rounding up of multiplication and rounding up of divisions. Okay, now see, you are getting confused because the question is asking you to round up to the nearest tens and there is only one digit, right? And in this case, the question is asking you to round up to the nearest nearest thousand, and there is only three digit. So what you can do in this case is, it is very simple. Okay, now see, there is only one digit in this case, right? And the question is asking you to round up to the nearest tens. Now, what you can do is, first you round up this number, okay? So rounding up 2, 6, 1, 5, okay? So we do 1, 5, 7. When you're rounding this number to the nearest tens, what happens is, you already know, since 7, when you are rounding up to the nearest tens, you have to look at the digit which is in ones place, that is, the digit is 7, right? So 7 is greater than 5, which means you have to add one number to the, add plus 1 to the other digit, that is the digit that is in tens place. So in this case, this becomes 2, 6, 1. So when you add 1 to this digit which is in tens place, that is, that becomes 6, and this becomes 0, right? Now, coming back to this number which has only one digit, that is 5. So when you round up this digit, this becomes 5. Now see, when you are rounding this number to the nearest tens, since there is only one digit, right? So you just look at this digit. This digit is equal to 5, right? So when it is equals to 5 or greater than 5, then you have to add one number to the next digit, that is, you have to add 1, which becomes, that means this becomes 1, 0. So when you are rounding off this digit, then this becomes to the nearest thing, then this becomes 10, right? Now all you have to do is multiply, so which is very easy. So now 2, 6, 1, 5, 7 into 5, sorry, into 10, sorry, 2, 6, 1, 5, 6, 0 into 10. This becomes 2, 6, 1, 6, 0. So 1, 6, 100, comma, 1,000, 10,000, comma, lakh. So this is your answer. Now moving on to the next question, that is rounding up of division to the nearest thousands, right? You have to round it up to the nearest thousands. So you have to do it in the same way. Now, so this 5, 7, 6, 9, 7 becomes, when you round up to the nearest thousand, this becomes, so you have to look at the digit which is in hundreds place, that, and that is 6, which is greater than 5. So this 1 is added to 7, so it becomes 8. The rest of the number becomes 0, right? So 8, 6, 5, this changes to, now whenever you are changing thousand, you have to look at the digit which is in hundreds place. Whenever you are changing to the nearest hundred, you have to look at the digit which is in tens place, right? Thousand like change got to talk about it. Thousand, nearest thousand na round of got to talk about it. If you look at one person, hundreds ko digit mein number cha, hundred digit mein kunche number cha, toh number cha. If you want to change to the nearest hundred, then you have to look at the digit which is in tens place. Would you? So in this case, if you want to change to the nearest thousands, then we have to look at the digit which is in hundreds place. So your hundreds place, now 1, 10, 100s place per digit, 8. So 8 is definitely greater than 5. That means if this is greater than 5, then 1 is added. So 1 eta chansa. That means 1 eta ayo. Would you? 1 eta chansa. This becomes 1, and the other number, it all becomes 0. Would you? So this number changes to, so this number changes to 1,000, because we are rounding up to the nearest 1,000. But you just have to divide. Now you have to divide 5, 7, 58000 divided by 1000. So when you divide this by 1000, so 1000 into 58 is 58,000. You have to subtract. So the remainder is 0, right? 0000. So the question is 58 and the remainder is 0. Okay? So I think after doing this, I've cleared your minds. And what I want you to do next is you can revise this once again. Okay, you can do this once again, or if you want to revise, you can do it in your rough copy. Okay, because you have already done it in the field copy, right? Now, what I want you to do today, what I want you to do next is look at the page number 33. Okay, there is a worksheet which is very easy. This worksheet is related to all the exercises that you have done previously, right? So this is very easy. You can do those do this worksheet from question number 1 to 8. You can do it because this is very easy, okay, since it is all related with the chapter. Fine, we can do this. So I want you to do this in your copy in a good handwriting, okay? And if you have any problem regarding this question, you can WhatsApp me as usual, okay? So please try to communicate with me, okay, if you have any problem. And we also feel like we have done something from our side, okay? If you at least try to communicate with us, fine. So please do this. And I would like to end my video here. Thank you very much.